Oh.
Love one.
This is going to be a sign of things to come here. They're both going to try and just feel each other off the table with their long pips. Third ball attack.
One.
One thing I'll say, especially about Yang Xiaoxin, she serves long more than any other player in the women's top 50. Almost every serve she does is attackable, but it's so quick.
2-1.
Quite intimidating, because you know it's going to come, but you don't know where and with what spin. Batra twiddling. Will she serve? She served with the pimples there.
1-3.
No spin. Got to have your eye on which side makes contact with the ball. She'll twiddle last minute. Well, last second. Wow.
2-3.
Straight out of the table tennis textbook there. Even with her lateral reach, Monica Batra could not even get back on ball. He's already played here on table one earlier on in the day. Batra alongside Satyang and then Shekaran. He bowed out in the mixed doubles. Shame for them because they were second seeds, but they lost to a very spirited young Japanese pair, Tagami and Miwa Haramoto. There he is, Satyang, her partner in crime.
3-4.
Serving long straight into the long pips. We'll probably get a ball back that has very little spin. If you give it no spin, you're going to get no spin back. 5-4. Is genius. Cheeky, cheeky play there. Love it. That is poetry in motion. Fascinating spectacle, this. If you do see long rallies, it's definitely not going to be loop-to-loop, I think it's fair to say.
Hey. 6-5.
In front for, I think, the first time in the game, Batra. Both of these players will try to protect their middle with the pips, but Batra, as the taller of the two players, has the biggest crossover section to hit into. She's probably top two or three tallest women in the top 100. I mean, you've got Chen Yi approaching there now. You've got Paul Canova, very tall. A couple of others, but they're the tallest.
6-7.
Look at this.
7-0.
She's using that backhand side there to actually kind of flick through. There's no spin on it. You've got to come through the ball. Drive through it. Got to time it just right, though. Good redirection there from Monica Batra. Nice early timing. Puts through that, butchered it, and levels up. 8-9. Good from Batra. She's not afraid to push because she knows what she's going to get from the backhand of her opponent, and then she'll get her forehand into play. 9-8 to the Indian. 8-9.
9-0.
It's a case of who's braver here. Who's going to use those pips more aggressively? Well, probably Yang Shaoxin. Big point there. Game point to Manika Batra. Finishes it off in 11, style, nine. A flat 11, kill nine. There.
Love one.
It's in these kind of matches with really short rallies that you really get a more obvious sense of the tactics players try and use to gain positional advantage on the table. Usually world champions aren't massively tall. That's because it's harder to play table tennis as a much taller player, and they're rarer, so the percentage drops even more. Nice intricacy there. Recovered well. Dairy Milk at the hashtag Cheer for All Sports are doing a promotion here, and it's giving some Indian fans a chance to look at Batra and watch the Indians play here on table one remotely. Quite funny to see them up there in the top corner. Good finish there.
Six love.
Half tempted to say something to see if they react, because I'm not sure if they can hear our commentary, but hello to you all tuning in. And give us a wave if you like. Well,
seven love.
Could this be a cold, hard donut? It's on the cards. Because she's a different player here, Yang Shaoxin. Batra's opening attack isn't the strongest, but she's better in the rally with the forehand. Initially, she takes it quite late, which gives her the only option of kind of spinning up. Her forehand is brilliant, though, Batra. She's improved it a lot. Oh, well, she could be on the verge of absolute embarrassment. There is nothing more humiliating in table tennis than being 11-0'd. In fact, there is. I'd find it more humiliating at this situation being given a mercy point. I'd rather someone just 11-0 me. Let's see what Yang Shaoxin chooses to do here. No mercy shown. Yang Shaoxin has not dropped a point in ages.
One
she gets
love.
Off to the better of the two starts here. Overcooks the second forehand, just drops the bat slightly there. Yang Shaoxin, Batra escapes there. She's in a passive position. This is the thing, Batra can only really use that as a shield. She can't really use it so aggressively, and this is why it is a stylistic limitation. might help you beat
3-1.
Most of the players outside the world top 30 having this kind of different style, but then when you come up against people who really know how to play you, there's not really much you can do about it. Just coming through with barely any wind back, most of it coming through the wrist there of Yang Xiaoxin. And Batra looks absolutely discombobulated. This onslaught continues. Oh my word. You won't see Batra getting more frustrated than a light racket toss on the table. She's won 1 point in the last 2 games. Why? She's just giving Yang Xiaoxin some easy third ball attacks. And she's not putting enough pressure on Yang Xiaoxin's forehand wide. She did it there, and then she went the other side. She has to show initiative. She has to switch the direction of play. Yang Xiaoxin is the one who will step the corner and play the forehand from the backhand side more regularly.
Led 2-5.
Bit of a safe serve. Carrying more than a billion hearts, Monica Batra looks puzzled. You can see the service success difference there between the two. Massively favouring Yang Xiaoxin. Yep, that's what happens to a lukewarm serve. If it drifts even a centimetre longer, your opponent is going to be able to play those quality of attacks at this level.
Five, six.
Well, she's clawing her way back. Backhand serve's working decently for her.
Six all.
Well, they're both making some uncharacteristic errors. Whoever gets through is going to have a really, really tough match because Bernie Soch of Romania is waiting in the round of 16 for the winner of this one. Fresh off a really good event at the Macau Champions where she beat Chen Xintong 3-1. Good control six from Batra, seven. And all of a sudden, she's in the lead.
Play, please. Seven all.
Six of the last eight for the Golden Girl of India.
8-7.
Yang Xiaoxin, quite expressive. I mean, usually she's very poker-faced. Both serving long so regularly, they're almost delaying the inevitable, aren't they? Because they know they're probably going to get their serve returned. So why not just try and surprise the opponent with a long one straight away? This is a very weird match. back and forth, back and forth. I mean, after winning the game 11-0 and being up, what, 4-1 in this one? She's trailing by 3 at the end of the game. And then plays the point of the match.
10-8.
It's so unpredictable. You would be an absolute numpty to bet on the outcome of this match because there's just no clear winner at any moment. Everyone's bamboozled. Oh, she saves another. Batchelor looking over to Satyan. Just trying to find some hope, even though she's the one with the game point. It's not the most positive body language there from Batchelor.
Let 10-9.
It's as clutch as it comes. She plays two wonderful counters and she saved 3 game points. This is crazy. It's a fourth point on the trot for Yang Xiaoxin. Well, this is going to be really tough for Batchelor, knowing she was 11-0'd and then had 3 game points and couldn't win it. This, it's like someone's got a bucket of salt and poured it in a wound, never mind a little tub. And just like that, she takes the game. Batchelor's doing well here to save face. Oh my goodness, that was amazing. The feeling that we just saw from Batchelor was immense, but yet it still wasn't enough. She just played a chop with the pips from the forehand side. At least she can see the lighter side in it, because if I was her, I would have had at least a red card at this moment. She is refusing to be beaten, Yang Xiaoxin. You've got to be really adaptive. She just looks like the player who can sort of anatomically contort her body in a few more ways. And I think as a tall player, you've got the long levers. It can be quite tiring to recover those long limbs. She's got a point. So that's the first meter of the mountain there. Into the crossover section that Batchelor can't protect that time because it wasn't played from forehand to backhand. It was played from backhand to forehand. That's against the momentum of the Indian. I mean, the body language of Batchelor here, it's like, oh, I better bounce just so I don't look too negative. I don't think she's really showing much optimism at all here. She's been flat on her feet. She just looks like someone's punctured all of the wind out of her. She's got to fight. The best thing she can do here, I think, is delay it. Take ages in between her serves. Just try and make Yang Xiaoxin impatient.
2-7.
But it was a rushed, flat hit, kind of Miyuki Hara style that she went for there, Batchelor. just not fully present right now, and it's understandable.
7-3.
There's a few things that have happened this match that will have broke the Indian fans out there. Oh well, it was a spinny brush up, but Batra would have liked to have put that one away, and she probably would most times. Got a nice angle with the receive and then went for the killer shot.
Led 8-3. 3-9.
Just getting Batra there a little bit wider, refusing to play into the Indians' comfort zone. And she's two away here. Yang is on the brink of victory. She can taste it.
3-10.
And it is 7 match points here to Yang Shaoxin. She's just shaking the bat there to fan herself or to just loosen the wrist. I'm not too sure, but it's 6 match points here.
10-5.
Good spirit shown here from Batra. It's probably coming too little too late. 7-10. And another saved.
6-10.
Third match point saved from Manika Batra. Couple more and you might begin to get some oohs and ahs from the crowd. But it's go, go, go for the Lone Ranger from Monaco. She is through to the round of 16.